When the Lord called me to be a prophet and when he revealed himself to me, he came up with rules and precept that I was supposed to follow. It was not easy. I was no longer free to do what I want, and I was complaining, for I could not live my life the way I wanted. Often when I want to go out, the Lord would say, "Michael, don't go out, stay at home. I want you indoor." I said, "Lord, this is unacceptable. This is not easy for me. If I knew that serving you will be like this, I would not have accepted this." I said, "Lord, you should have explained to me very well how tough it is to be your servant. I would not have accepted this offer. Every move I make, you are opposing me. And you are talking too much. You are restricting me from doing so many things. You don't want me to go to the market and to visit friend." The Lord said, "Michael, I need you to be indoor. I want you retreated in secret." But this was not easy given my background. I don't stay home. I am always out with friend doing shopping and enjoying life. As soon as the Lord came in my life, he interrupted my way of life. The Lord was not smooth, but he was tough. The Lord was changing my way of life by force. My brother, when your pastor asks you to do things, you think it's democracy, but this is not the case with the Lord. Whatever reason and justification I put forward, when the Lord says something, he does not budge. When he says something, he maintains his word, and the word of the Lord prevail. The Lord is strict and disciplined. When I retreated indoor, there were days where the heaven was opened, and the angels of God descended in my room in order to remind me not to go out. And when I wanted to provide explanation as to why I have to go out, I saw the heaven shutting down and these angels disappear. They did not mind hearing my explanation. All that matter for them is that the will of the Lord will be done on the earth as it is in heaven. And this was repetitive. I complain in myself that this was tough. One day as the Lord came to visit me, I said, "Lord, I want to talk to you." He encouraged me to speak my mind, and he was silent listening to me. I said, "Lord, why did you not choose my sister for this work? I am tired of your rules and restriction. You don't want me to do this and that. You don't want me to go out. I am reduced to do what you want and I have no freedom." When I spoke this way, the Lord began to laugh and said, "I am teaching you something, my brother." The Lord laughed and he also got angry. One day the Lord told me how he was hurt when the gospel singer Sister Marie resorted to occultism. He told me, "Michael, my heart was broken when Sister Marie went to the other side. I was telling the Lord his prescription are tough. Had I known it will be like this, I would have said no." The Lord said, "You already said yes. Your yes will remain yes. You will understand what I want you to become and what you will be for the world. All these restriction and taboo is not for you. It is for what you will be for the world." I said, "Lord, why did you not choose my sister Judith?" The Lord said, "No, not her." The Lord said, "Michael, I chose you before the birth of your parent." I said, "What do you mean before the birth of my parent?" The Lord said, "Long before your parent marriage, I have already written and determined the family where you were supposed to be born, and I had decided the manner I will use you." I said, "How?" The Lord said, "Read the book of Jeremiah and see how I called him." Whatever the Lord was telling me, he was given Bible passage. When he gave me Brother Alan's song to sing in order to worship him, he gave me the passage to read, and when I read that passage, I saw that the song was drawn from this passage. The Lord said, "You will understand me with time. I cause your parent to meet and get married, and I took them to Pastor Alexander ministry, for I wanted you to be a fruit of his ministry." The Lord said, "When you read the scripture, you will see that there is 9 gift of the Spirit, but you have received 7 of them. I gave them to you so that the world will get something from you. I gave them not for you but for the world. Your father was supporting my work with money, offering and tithe, as written in Malachi 10. Brother, I remember I was in Angola in the capital Luanda. The Lord sent me to a family that invited me. When I went there to preach the good news, I was dressed in lady pant. I had makeup on my face. I was walking in the street with painted face, false hair and lady pant trousers. Right there in the street, I heard the powerful voice of the Lord, who was laughing and despising me. The Lord said, "Is this really a pastor with all these makeup and lady pant and false hair?" I said in my heart, "I am going to preach the gospel, but why is the Lord speaking like this about me?" I was curious, but I continue my way. When I got where the Lord sent me, I preached the word to this family. It is when I was leaving the compound of this family, that I heard the thunderous voice of the Lord again. He asked me, What did you preach them? The Lord said, Michael, I am asking you this question for I did not see what you preached them. I said, Lord, you wanted me to come and preach here, why do you speak like that? The Lord said, I saw nothing and I heard nothing. The Lord said, Michael, with your makeup, outward adornment and appearance, really, how can you really preach my word to this people with these items on your body? Your appearance and dressing itself should be a message. Now with your lady pant and makeup, what did you preach them? You should preach with your outward appearance and then your word. I came to understand that the Lord look at the heart and the outside. It was a mistake to keep saying the Lord only look at the heart. The Lord told me, this is how a person that is preaching others should look like and dressed. The Lord showed me three women. The first woman that the Lord showed me was dressed in African loincloth. Another woman was dressed in long robe and shoes. Another woman was in long skirt and blouse. The Lord said, this is how a woman is supposed to dress. The Lord said, any woman dressed in lady trousers or lady pant is naked in the spirit world. The Lord instructed me to read Deuteronomy 22 verse 5, a woman must not wear men's clothing, and a man must not wear women's clothing, for whoever does these things is detestable to the Lord your God. I told the Lord I am accustomed to lady pant, and I continue to put on lady pant despite the Lord warning, but the Lord did not leave me alone, for whenever I was putting lady pant the Lord made it uncomfortable for me. I mean, I always felt itchy. I am speaking so that I will not be judged. Maybe your ear is far from the voice of the Lord, but since mine is closer, I will speak out. God's servant need to wear skirt and robe. You don't need lady pant or trousers. The Lord said, when you are coloring your lip with red lipstick, you are correcting me and telling me I did not make you good enough. Back then I was in Indian wig. I was putting big earring in order to feel that I am something. When the Lord told me to remove these earring, I complain. I said, Lord, can my beauty be remarkable to the people without earring? I am dependent on these things. The Lord said, don't put them, and let's see if you are not beautiful. But few days later I decided to put earring. I put on the first one. When I wanted to put the other one on my ear, it fell to the floor of my room. When I began to look for it, I was never able to find it, though it fell to the floor of my room, which was a place where it could not disappear, yet I was never able to find it for it disappear, since the Lord was insisting. One day, I had gathered all of these beauty product and jewelry in order to throw them in the bin, but there was still rebellion in me. I was reluctant to throw them. I took sheer tight and I put it on, and I went out to buy something to eat. I saw that people in the street were all looking at me, as if I was naked. I felt shame and returned quickly back home. The Lord told me that these wig and weaving have spiritual implication, and you must separate from them. The Lord also revealed to me that when we use the things of the world, like beauty product, we end up developing two identity in the spirit world. Many women had double identity in the spirit. They are living on the surface of the earth, and they are also living underwater. This is simply because they are attached to the property of the queen of the sea. They are failing to separate from wearing wig, eyelash, nail and earring. The Lord showed me a lady walking the street and he said, Michael, look at her. When I look at this lady, I saw that she was walking in the street, but she was also walking in the world that is underwater. Because of the items she was wearing, I understood that she had two identity thanks to these property of the enemy. I could see her in the physical and in the marine world. My sister, even these cracked pant and skirt belong to the queen of the sea. When you fail to get rid of these items, the enemy has legality over you. The Lord made me understand that fashion and modern dressing is manipulation and witchcraft. Fashion belong to the queen of the sea. Fashion items bring demon in our home. The Lord told me, women of the world are correcting me, telling me that I have not made them well. My sister, beauty does not come from beauty product. In the end we will be judged if we fail to submit, for I am talking as a spokesman of the Lord. The Lord instructed me to wear veil and not to put on earring. He gave 1 Corinthians. The Lord show me that whenever these beauty product are to be put in circulation, and before the woman of the world used them, first and foremost the queen of the sea has to use and apply them. In a vision the Lord took me underwater and show me how they design lipstick. He said, behold, look, This is how they designed lipstick before it reached your home where you use them. The Lord Show Me Lady pant, fashion and wig that were being designed in the marine world. He told me the one who used these items before sending them to the earth is the Queen of the Sea, brother. When I look at the Queen of the Sea in the marine world, I saw that she had a lot of hair, that she was cutting and giving to the manufacturing industry, for the women of the world on the surface to wear. The Lord show me that when we comb and cut hair, these little hair that are cut get collected by these Lady of Water. Whenever I saw servant of God wearing sleeveless blouse, I feel pain for them. This is the design of the Queen of the Sea in charge of fashion. When I saw the bride wearing sleeveless wedding robe, it's regrettable. These kind of clothes belong to the Queen of the Sea. They are his property that give her power to locate and identify you in the system, for you have their property. You have double identity without knowing. I used to do weaving with these fake hair, but the Lord encouraged me to have my own hair. I was sad when I abandoned Brazilian and Indian hair. I was addicted to expensive wig, but the Lord was opposed, and when I left them, I was in shock, but the Lord kept saying, "Look now, how you are natural, just look at you, how you are beautiful, you don't need these wig, I love you daughter, smile." But I was in shock. The Lord told me, "I don't want to see sin and any sinful items around you giving legality to Satan and being an open door to the adversary. As long as you keep their property, they will keep coming to your home. Remove these items to get them out of your houses." The Lord said, "Since I am with you in your house, I don't want to see a sinful item in this house." When I remember